whoever tries to knock you down, just stay away. They're not worth it anyway. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk about 5 keys to success in starting a fitness journey. So my first tip is diet and exercise. Without proper nutrition and proper exercise, you will not be able to see results and you will quickly get frustrated. So my first recommendation is to have a healthy diet. This doesn't have to be 100% of the time. You want it to be something that you're going to stick to, something that's going to make you happy and obviously see results. So about 95% of the time, make sure that you're making really good choices. And then of course, at the end of the week, reward yourself with a cheat meal or something that will make you happy so that you can stay on track every single day. Make sure you're getting a good workout. My recommendation would be to work out 4 or 5 days a week for about an hour and 15 minutes. Do a little bit of cardio, really focus on weight training if you're trying to build muscle or even lose body fat. It's super important to add resistance training into your routine. And also take time to relax, recover, and recharge. This means that you should be taking rest days. You should be giving your body a chance to relax and to stretch and do things that make you happy and just stress-free. So you can do a yoga class. You can be stretching for an hour on your own. Get a massage, go get your nails done, go get your hair done, go for a walk. Do something that makes you happy and take a few days, about 2 days of rest every single week. Also, if you are totally new to fitness, have no idea how to work out or what to eat or anything like that, I do recommend getting a personal trainer. They know how to motivate you and give you proper exercises and a nutrition plan and all those sorts of things. But you do have to do your research. Not every personal trainer is good. Not everybody knows exactly what they're talking about. So make sure you do your research and find somebody who has been doing it for a little bit of time, who does have a good amount of clientele and experience, and that has seen results and can give you exactly what you're looking for. Some personal trainers are specialized in certain areas, so you wouldn't be wanting somebody who only coaches people for marathons if you're trying to lose body fat. So just find exactly what you're looking for in that person and you will see great results. My second tip is planning ahead. Now, this would be for your meals. If you want a meal prep, it's a great way to plan ahead. It does take a little bit of time, so maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, and you could get pretty much all of your meals done for the week so that you don't have to worry about lunch or dinner or even breakfast. You could have it all ready to go so that it's just super quick. When you're hungry, you grab it and you can eat. I love doing it. It really helps me stay on track because when I'm hungry, if I don't have my meals ready to go, I typically would just grab whatever's right in front of me, and usually whatever is the easiest to grab is usually not the healthiest. So if I have a meal ready to go, I'm less likely to binge or overeat on things that I know I shouldn't. Also, plan ahead with your workouts. Write down exactly what you want to work out that day. I use my FitnessPal for my food to track my food, and then I also use a calendar and I write down exactly what I worked out that day, how many calories I burned. It's a great way and a great tool to kind of help you for the future and reflect back on what you have done in the past. Also, really figure out what your goals are. Why is it a goal? How long has it been a goal? And so that this way you can know exactly what you're fighting for every single day. So that whenever you're tired or not really feeling like going to the gym or eating healthy, think about what your goals are and it will help you stay on track. My third tip is to stay in a positive environment and stay away from negative people. There are always going to be people that will either mock you or not agree with what you're doing or try to intimidate you or, I don't know, make fun of you. So because there's always going to be people like that, you have to just stay on your path and just keep on doing what you're doing. Do your best to ignore them and prove them wrong. Kind of use that fire that they're adding to you as a great way to push you further into the best person that you're trying to be. And by doing so in a positive way, you're actually going to be benefiting yourself the most by not getting aggravated and feeding into it. This will help keep your stress levels down, and it will just really help you stay focused on your journey if you can stay in a positive environment. You also want to be around like-minded people. If you are surrounded with people that really appreciate and believe in your journey, you're going to be more likely to stay on track because you guys will all be having the same things to talk about, doing the same things, and all that. My fourth key to success is finding your motivation. What drives you? What is your goal? What will keep you motivated? Now, something that you can do is either have sayings or quotes in your room or on the refrigerator or pictures or whatever it is that will help remind you exactly what you're trying to achieve. If it's an event, put a picture or the name of an event somewhere where you're going to see it. Usually the kitchen or the pantry or in your room is a great place because you're in there every single day. And the pantry and the refrigerator can sometimes be an enemy for some people if you don't have your nutrition exactly on point or if you get distracted in some sort of way. Also, how long has your goal been a goal? If it's been a really long time and you can say to yourself, well, I've never seen myself in a size zero, or I've never seen myself confident in a bathing suit. Well, maybe it's time to make it happen this year. Maybe it's time you do exactly what you want to see that goal a reality. Set reminders that will tell you exactly what you need to do to stay motivated, helping you drink your water and just stay on top of all those sorts of things. My fifth tip would be to stay committed and dedicated. Now, if you're really committed to working on your goal, you're going to see results. If you are persistent and passionate about why you're doing what you're doing, you're going to see results. And for this, it could be with anything. It could be with school, it could be with work, it could be for your fitness journey. If you're really committed, you're going to see results. If you're just kind of going with the flow and not really caring or cheating here and there or not really giving your workout 100% and, you know, just kind of going with the flow, you're going to get that kind of result. But if you're really strong and passionate and persistent about what you're doing, that's how strong your goal is going to be. So just give every single day your 100%. If you mess up and you go crazy one day, it's okay. It's the past. Just go on to the next day and work really hard in the gym or work really hard on your nutrition. And I'm telling you, in like 3 days or 2 days, you're gonna forget about how bad you ate that one day, and it's not even going to affect the scale anymore. So it's not a problem as long as you keep like going forward and don't go backwards and keep on doing the same thing. You're going to be totally fine. One day is not going to ruin your journey, and don't let it affect your brain in such a way where you're like dying, because you're not dying. Also, find your strength and find your happiness. If you truly love lifting weights, then lift weights. If you hate doing cardio, don't let that be your routine, because you're not going to stick with it. I personally love lifting weights. I don't really enjoy doing cardio. I know that I do have to do it a little bit, but cardio is not my main source of my workout. Right now, I'm maybe doing 1 to 2 days a week of cardio. If I really wanted to see results, I could bump it up a little bit more, but I'm happy with what I'm doing, so I'm gonna keep on doing it. There's no point in doing something that I don't wanna do because it's not gonna make me happy in the long run. So I hope you guys enjoyed these 5 keys to success. I also wanted to quickly update you guys on what I'm doing currently for my fitness journey. I believe I have stayed the same weight since last week. I've been kind of playing with my macros and just kind of figuring that out because it's always going to be a trial and error to see exactly what works for you and what doesn't. I have noticed that my strength has gone up a lot, so that makes me really happy, and I'm not really too concerned that I didn't lose any weight this week. That's totally fine. I'm still doing really, really good. I am looking a lot more toned and defined, so it's all good. I do have a lot more energy, so I'm happy with how I feel. I know at one point I was a little bit tired, but I'm really feeling great. I've been keeping up with my gallon of water every single day. I've been keeping up with my supplements and my workouts 5 days a week. I've been really, really good with my nutrition. So I'm happy with where I'm at, and I'm going to keep on striving for the best. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you learned anything, please give this video a thumbs up. Also, if you'd like to see anything in the future, please leave that in the comment section down below, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys. Help remind you exactly what you're trying to achieve. If it's an event, put a picture or the name of an event somewhere where you're going to see it, usually the kitchen or the pantry.